What's the relationship between supplementing your interaction and the computational fabrication area? So in our field, we deal with the relationship between human and computation. So we try every possible means to really understand and redefine and the relationship between human and computation. We call it interaction or interface design. So essentially, it's to find ways to humanize the interaction with computation. So when the computer was invented, it was mostly 0 and 0, 0 and 1. So it wasn't really accessible by the majority. Only very professional experts could leverage the power of computation. So that is why, indeed, the field of human interaction was born. So there are pioneers from Zero Parks and later on a bunch of Silicon Valley companies started looking into this idea of representing information in a more human understandable way. That is how graphic user interface was born. So basically you use graphic components that are visual and intuitive to human to access digital information. Everybody understand what a trash can is. So people started to move this metaphor from the physical world into this digital environment. That really opened the age of personal desktop or personal computation in general. So as the world is developing, we are moving into another age where we see distributed computation. So in our field, there's a pioneer researcher called Mark Weiser. He had this statement that computation should be coming out of the screen and be embedded into your daily life. It should disappear eventually and weave seamlessly into our physical life. So this is his exact quote. So the most profound technology are those that disappear. They weave themselves into the fabric of daily life until they are distinguishable from it. So the best example he gave was those tablets that can be distributed in the working environment
inside the room. But later on, you know, it opened the whole field of Internet of Things and embedded electronics and embedded computation in general. So that's already kind of state of art. And where we are now, just in terms of the field of HCI, so we are moving into a new paradigm of different varieties of interfaces that allow people to engage with computation. So that includes a lot of gadgets and AR technology and virtual reality and even a physical embodiment of personalized robots. So these are all ways we perceive as interface to access computation. However, there is one thing that you guys notice. These are all gadgets, and these are all embedded electronics. So I'm not sure if the world needs more gadgets, first of all. And second, if it is the true vision of Mark Weiser, which is to embed and make information disappear. So we still have a lot of information that's floating around. And also, some of them, they don't exist in the physical world. For example, no matter how much you love virtual reality, by the end of the day, you go back home, you sleep in a physical bed, and you sit on a physical couch. So there are inherent conflicts between how our computational technology is developing and also how we as human beings want to enjoy and embrace the physical reality. That's why a group of us started to push a bit of the boundary of computation. And we wanted to make information disappear, make it disappear by indeed seamlessly embedding those information and computational power into physical material. And we looked into nature and realized there are a lot of adaptive and responsive behaviors that kind of behave like computer interfaces, but without using power, and can be really adaptive and even mutating and evolving through time, basically more intelligent than current state of art of computation. or computation in a general sense. For example, Pinecone can open and close. Transformation is being powered by rain in this case, so the power comes for free. And also there are a group of other natural organisms that can transform in shape, in its physical property, adaptive to each other, to the environment, and sometimes to human beings as well. So that really leads us to this broader context of material science, and indeed also biology and chemistry. So in the history of computer science, we are built on top of silicon chips. So in the other world of physical science, we build our computation based on the physics and also the material. So we wanted to see whether we can leverage some of the computational power from almost the other side of the world for computer interface design. So the question behind us, basically the maker community of human-computer interaction, is when computation is shifted to material, can human computation interface also shift to the physical materials? Information in that way will truly disappear, as Mark Wither envisioned, and also weave into our daily life. So we are switching from human computation interface to human material interface. And if you expand this a little bit, so we are extremely interested as a field to understand better how human can interact with the material, the machine, and also the processes to generate those interfaces and materials. So three aspects: material, how material can be adaptive and carry information and be responsive, like how sometimes computer can behave, and also how machines can be cooperative, how machines can allow us to do more things and to do things that a human by him or herself cannot do, and also something that cannot be done by pure machine either. So that's why we're talking about the collaboration between the two. And also how the processes can be more and more interactive. For example, can we leverage the VR technology to allow us to predict what is the final form would be in the middle of a 3D print? So that is my very brief intro for HCI. It is a big field. People deal with all kinds of things. But this is a small group of us who are trying to push the boundary between, I would say, the material and also the computer science. So with that, I'd like to invite our HCI special invited guest speakers, Laura Derendorf. Yes, here, who are going to elaborate better and more in depth the relationship between machines, human, and processes.